Hi everyone. Today we shall start a new topic for the sixth grade six, that is citizenship. As you all know, that a fundamental basic need for every citizen or every individual in a country is food and shelter. See, rather than food and shelter, we should know ourselves. I mean, we should be identified in our society. For a recognition of every individual of a nation, or to identification of every individual of a nation, there is a proper system by which every individual of a nation or every citizen of a nation can be identified for the government or themselves. So, such kind of system is known as citizenship. Today we have we shall study in detail about the kinds of citizenship and importance of a citizenship and meanings of a citizenship. As you all know that we are all citizens of India, it is a basic need for every individual of our nation to obtain a citizenship of India. So, see, citizenship is having a very broad meaning. I mean, whatever the project are taken place in our nation, whatever the plans are executed in our nation, that should be approved by the every citizen of our nation. If a government is going to run in our nation, or if a government is going to rule our nation, the government should be elected by the citizens of our nation. So, citizenship is having a vast meaning and a very much importance in the system of a democracy. Complete system of a democracy is dependent on the system of citizenship. In the same way, the meaning of citizenship is, the term citizenship can be explained as a process of documentation, a process of documentation by which the ruling government can opt the data, of every individual who is going to live or sustain in the nation. See, why they are needed, our data? What is the use of collection of data, and what is the use of creating citizenship? The term citizenship, the term citizenship is very important to lead the government or even to lead our life also. So, because by this citizenship or by this collected data, our government is able to give any kind of developmental programs or ensure the security of every citizen's life of our nation. So, citizenship is a very important term, and it is a basic need for every person who is going to live in our nation. And next, importance of citizenship. Citizenship plays a very important role. Why? Because without knowing this data, or without collecting this data, a government cannot plan anything, cannot assure the life of a individual who is going to live in our nation. Basically, citizenship plays a very important role because a citizen who is citizen of our nation is only the person able to elect the government of our nation. So, citizenship plays a very important role in a future of every nation, or in the democratic system of every nation. I think they have not mentioned in our textbook about the kinds of citizenship. Basically, there are two kinds of citizenship in our all over the world. The democratic countries are having two kinds of citizenship. One is single citizenship and dual citizenship. The term single citizenship means a citizenship is only one for entire nation. The nations like India, Pakistan, China, Sri Lanka, and Myanmar, Bhutan, and Nepal, these are the nations which are having a single kinds of citizenship. I mean, if we are going to enroll our citizenship for a government, if it is updated, only one citizenship is valid all over the nation. But in some different nation, we are going to see the dual citizenship. I mean, the individual of that nation or a citizen of that nation should get two citizenship. I mean, one citizenship is for a state and another citizenship is for a nation. For example, USA is a country, a well-developed country. America is following a dual citizenship system. Why? Because they are going to say, we have done this system for the purpose of security, but it hurts or it damages the integrity and unity of a nation. So, the makers of our constitution or our great leaders decided to give only one kind of citizenship for our nation. Because of citizenship, every individual of our India, every citizen of our India is able to live anywhere or is able to travel anywhere all over the nation. Because of this, single citizenship is a very good format or a very good system which is adopted by the democratic countries like India, Pakistan, Afghan, Bhutan, Nepal, China, Sri Lanka and many other countries. Some developed countries they have adopted the dual citizenship. I mean, if a person who is living in one state, if he wish to travel for another state, he should apply for the visa. But in case of our nation, I mean in case of India, every citizen of India can travel anywhere in the India. But if he wish to travel for any other countries, at that time a question of his citizenship, question of his visa, question of his passport will be arrival. Until that, there is no restriction for the individual of India to move from one place to another place in our nation. This is all about the meaning and importance of citizenship. We shall discuss about the methods. I said you about the citizenship. What are the process to acquire the citizenship? How we can get the citizenship? How we are going to able to acquire the citizenship? There are some methods to acquire the citizenship. I mean, without any methods or without any system, we can't get anything in this world or anything in our nation itself. So there are some methods. There are some methods to acquire the citizenship. In the same way, the constitution of our they have mentioned in the constitution of our nation, that is some methods to acquire the citizenship and some methods to giving up or losing the citizenship. See, I said you before that citizenship plays a very important role in the development of our country. So they have mentioned some methods. I mean, every individual who is going to live in India or is going to sustain in India, we should provide him citizenship in the proper way. Every child which took birth in our nation, every child which took birth in any other nation for the Indian parents, he is going to become the citizen of India. If any child took birth in our nation, directly is going to be a citizen of India by the first method, that is citizenship by birth. We are going to see nearly four methods to acquire the citizenship, and we are going to see the three methods to giving up or losing the citizenship. The first method by which we can acquire the citizenship is acquiring citizenship by birth. This is a method by which every individual or every child took birth in India after his age of 18. Until the age of 18, he is a population of India, he is considered as a child of India. After his age of 18, he is considered as a citizen of India. This is the first kind of process by which every individual or every child taken birth in our nation is going to become directly the citizen of India. It is known as acquiring the citizenship by the method that is known as by birth. Next is by inheritance. What do you mean by inheritance? The term inheritance can be defined as a transfer of citizens or a transferring his rights from parents to children. Any child which took birth in any place of a world, in any other place of a world, but it is a child of Indian parents. Such kind of person or a child can acquire the Indian citizenship by the second method, that is known as acquiring citizenship by the method of inheritance. First method is acquiring the citizenship by birth. I mean, every individual or any child which take place, I mean, it take birth in our nation is directly going to be a citizen of India. That is known as getting citizenship by birth. And next is the getting citizenship by inheritance. I mean, any individual or any child which take birth in any part of a world, but it is a child of Indian parents. I mean, a small kid taken birth in Afghanistan or America, Sri Lanka, Japan, Australia, anywhere, but his father and mother are basically Indians, and he is going to become an Indian citizen by the process of inheritance. A child which is taken birth in any place of any other place of the world, but his parents are basically Indians, at that time he is going to directly become the citizen of India. First is by birth, I mean the kid which is taken birth in our nation, Holy Land India, is going to become a citizen of India. Next method is getting or acquiring a citizenship by the method of inheritance. And the third method is the getting or acquiring citizenship by the method of registration. What do we mean by registration? For these two also we are going to register. I mean, when we are going to become 18 years old, we are going to register our citizenship by the near the office, which we are going to call them as BLOs, Blank Electoral Officers. We are going to give our details to them. I mean, our birth certificate or TC or any identical proof which we are having. We are going to submit them, and they are going to enroll our citizenship, and they are going to issue a voter ID or a epic card for us. The same way, in the form of inheritance also, we are going to consult for our office, and we are going to submit our citizenship documents, our parents' documents, and we are going to get the Indian citizenship. In the same way, in these two kinds of citizenship, a person who directly or indirectly belongs to India, who is having a connectivity in India, who is having a genetical connection within India, who is having an economical or cultural connection with India, is going to take an Indian citizenship in these two ways. But when we are going to discuss about the third way by which we are going to acquire the citizenship, is very little different when we are comparing these two ways. This is a platform or a kind of a method by which any individual from any part of world can acquire the citizenship of our nation. A citizenship of India is very open to any person in the world, but he should fulfill some terms and conditions. See, some countries in the world, they are going to allow the dual citizenship. I mean, if a person is having any other citizenship of any other country, if he wish to take the citizenship of one country, they are going to be free. I mean, they are able to accept. But when we are going to study in the case of India, we are not accepting such kind of citizenship. A person should give up the citizenship before which he is having, and he should be resident of our nation for minimum 5 years. After being resident of India after the minimum 5 years, he will be able to get the citizenship of our nation. A person who is going to reside in India for minimum 5 years, and he should give up the citizenship of any other nation which he was belonged before, at that time he will be able to get the citizenship of India by the method of registration. And some other important terms and conditions are there. A person should be a resident of India for minimum 5 years, and he should give up the citizenship of any other country before he is having, and he should not participate in any criminal activities in the country in which he was living before. These are the three conditions by which any person in the world can be able to get the citizenship of India. This is the third method by which any person in the world can acquire the citizenship of India, that is known as getting the citizenship by registration. The next and fourth method is by incorporation. What do you mean by incorporation? If the armed forces of our nation or any political arrangement of our nation is going to acquire any part of other country, if we are going to acquire some parts of Pakistan, we are going to acquire some parts of Sri Lanka, we are going to acquire some parts of Nepal, Bhutan, or any other nation, gradually the peoples are resident who are living in such areas are becoming the citizens of our nation. If an Indian armed force acquiring on any our neighboring countries, it's our bonded duty to protect the peoples who are living in such acquired area. So the government is responsible to provide the citizenship for such peoples who are the place which is acquired by our Indian armed forces or political arrangement. At all the time we are not going to acquire any places by the armed force itself. In some cases or in some terms, we are going to acquire the other place or other part of any other country by the political agreements or treaties also. So whatever the condition is, if India is acquired any part of other nation, we should provide the citizenship of our nation to the people or residents who are going to lead their life in such areas. The acquiring citizenship in such manner is known as acquiring citizenship or getting citizenship by the method which is known as incorporation. Next, these are all the four methods by which any individual or individual of India can acquire the citizenship. The first method is acquiring citizenship by birth. I mean, every individual, every kid which to take birth in our nation is directly being a citizen of India after his age of 18. Next, by inheritance. A kid or a child which is taken birth in any part of a world, but the parents of that kid is belongs to India. If they are the citizens of India, that child or a kid is going to become the citizen of India after his age of 18. In the same way, in the case of birth also, every child or a kid which took birth in our nation after his age of 18 is going to become the citizen of India. Next, getting citizenship by the registration. If any individual or any person all over the world, if he wish to become a citizen of India, he should register his citizenship. But there are some terms and conditions. He should be residents of India for nearly minimum 5 years, and he should give up the citizenship which before he is having, and he should not participate in any criminal activities in the country which he was before he was a citizen. And the fourth and last method by which we can acquire the citizenship is citizenship by the incorporation. I mean, if a armed forces of India or a government of India is going to acquire some part of any other nation, such peoples who are resident of such acquired place are going to get the citizenship of our nation. Such kind of system by which we are going to give the citizenship for those peoples is known as giving a citizenship by the method incorporation. Next, these are the four methods by which we can get the citizenship. I mean, these are the four methods which are formed in our constitution for giving the citizenship. Next, there are some methods by which we are going to lose our citizenship. There are three methods by which we are going to lose our citizenship, that is, losing citizenship by reconciliation. I mean, if a citizen of India is moved to any other nation, renunciation. This is the method which is known as renunciation. If a citizen of India is moved to any other nation, if I am a citizen of India, I am going to move for Australia. I am going to get my citizenship there. At that time, automatically my Indian citizenship will be cancelled. If a citizen of India is moved to any other nation, he registered his citizenship in that nation, automatically his citizenship in India will be cancelled. Automatically it will be taken back or it is cancelled. Such kind of process by which we are going to give up or lose our citizenship is known as giving up or losing our citizenship by the method of renunciation. Next, second method, losing or giving up the citizenship by the method of termination. I mean, if we are going to give up our citizenship, by giving an application, by giving a document, I mean, I am a citizen of India, but I wish to cancel my citizenship. I wish to get my citizenship in any other country. I have got my citizenship in other country. So please cut off my citizenship or please cancel my citizenship. If we are going to apply or if we are going to give an application for a concerned officer, he is going to cancel our citizenship. Such kind of process is known as giving up or losing of a citizenship by the termination. Next, by deprivation. I mean, if a person did any criminal activities, if he is supported for the anti-national things, if any important defense documents are shared with the anti-nationalists or terrorists or some other enemy nations, or if a person is not loyal to the law, if a person is not loyal to the ruling government, if a person is not loyal to the judicial system, if a person is not obeying the rights and duties which are formed by our constitution, such kind of persons are taken back, the government is going to take back their citizenship. That kind of process is known as taking back or losing the citizenship by the deprivation. These are the methods by which we can acquire the citizenship, and these are the methods by which we are going to give up our citizenship. And this completes your topic. That it is a very small topic which is mentioned in your textbook. Actually, it is an introduction part for your civics topics. This is all about the topic citizenship. In this topic, we have discussed about the meaning of citizenship. We have discussed about the importance of citizenship, and we shall discuss about some features of citizenship. What are the features of citizenship? By the citizenship, it is helpful for the government to know about the peoples of the nation. And by the citizenship, we can get the specialties which are going to form or given for the peoples by the government. And it is very useful for the government to maintain the collection of data for the future development and planning of economic planning. And citizenship is very useful to choose the government. Only by the system of citizenship. The system of citizenship is a very important thing in the democracy, because the democracy is there only because of citizenship. By the system of citizenship, we are going to elect our government. It plays a very important role in the modification or administration system of our government. These are all the features of our citizenship, and we have discussed about the method of acquiring citizenship, that is by birth, by inheritance, by registration, and by the incorporation. And also we have discussed about the methods by which we are going to lose our citizenship, that is by renunciation, by termination, and by deprivation. This is all about the topic, that is citizenship. In the next topic regarding the civics part, we shall discuss about the national symbols. Thank you, everyone.